let's start talking about tissue. This module is pretty intense. We talk about the four primary tissue types, and then within each primary tissue type, there are subtypes. And so for each of the tissues, each of the subtypes, you will need to know what it looks like, what the structure of that tissue is, where you would find that tissue, the location, and then the very specific function of that tissue. Now, there are four primary tissue types: epithelial tissue, connective tissue, muscle tissue, and nervous tissue. Epithelial tissue covers body surfaces. Your epidermis is epithelial tissue. It lines all of your tracts, your digestive tract, your respiratory tract, the urinary tract, the genital tract. All the tracts are lined with epithelial tissue. It also lines your body cavities. Remember, your thoracic body cavity, your abdominopelvic body cavity, the lining is epithelial tissue. Glands are made up of epithelial tissue, as well as ducts. They're also made up of epithelial tissue. All of our hollow organs are lined with epithelial tissue. So the lining of the stomach is epithelial tissue. So epithelial tissue provides a barrier between your body and some sort of environment. If it's your epidermis, it's this external environment. If it's the lining of your stomach, it's the acidic environment of your stomach. We're going to explore epithelial tissue first. Connective tissue supports the body and binds its organs. It provides cushion in the form of fat tissue. It provides resistance to pulling forces in your tendons and ligaments. It provides a framework for your skin in your dermis. Bone is connective tissue, blood is connective tissue, all cartilage is connective tissue. It's a really broad category. That'll be the second tissue type we explore in this module. Muscle tissue is specialized to contract. Luckily, there are only three types of muscle tissue, and they are categorized based on their function. Skeletal muscle tissue is all of the muscle that you're probably familiar with, like your biceps and your triceps and your gluteus maximus, the muscles that you're familiar with. But also, your heart is composed of muscle, but that's specifically cardiac muscle. And then smooth muscle is found in the walls of hollow organs, like the wall of the stomach, the wall of blood vessels, the wall of the gallbladder, the small intestine, the uterus, the urinary bladder. It's involuntary, as is cardiac muscle tissue. So we'll explore muscle tissue third. Lastly, nervous tissue. Nervous tissue is composed of a really important cell called the neuron. The neuron sends and receives electrical information and transmits that information throughout the body. We find nervous tissue in the brain, the spinal cord, and your nerves. Now, don't let the simplicity of what we cover in this module about nervous tissue fool you, because the nervous system is a really intense module, but for our tissue conversation, it's going to be pretty straightforward. Okay, so let's first talk about epithelial tissue.